I'm going to cover four basic strokes that you use, jigging strokes that you use when you're using a spoon when you're fishing walleyes through the ice. One is the first typical cadence that a lot of people use. In fact, it's probably the most popular. That's about a 2 foot lift, and then it drops on a totally free fall. And you stop for a second, pause, lift, basically stop, lift, stop. And it's about a foot and a half to 2 foot stroke. That works very well to call the fish in or when the fish are aggressive. Most of the time they'll hit that bait once you pause it. There's a variation of that, and I call it the short stroke. It's about a 6 inch to a foot hop, and you'll notice that if the fish are swimming up to your lure and they're turning away and they won't bite it, go to the short stroke. Go to the 6 inch to 1 foot stroke. I like to do them so that the pause isn't real long. It basically will also call the fish in, but it doesn't necessarily scare them away. There are times where you'll mark a lot of fish right on the bottom, and sometimes you can get those fish to bite. So what you do is you free spool your spoon to the bottom, and then you do 6 inch hops. You go lift and let it crash right back into the bottom, lift, let it crash back into the bottom. I don't let it sit on the bottom for more than a split second, and then I'm jigging again. You'll be surprised. There are days where they just crush that. And then the last stroke is one that you can use almost any time when a fish is coming in, and that's the shake. It's just like what the bluegill and the crappie fishermen do. You can shake that spoon, especially if you have like a half a minnow on the end of it. You just shake it and then try to raise that fish off the bottom. Stop once in a while, shake, stop once in a while. And that basically will entice a lot of those fish to bite. So you've got four basic strokes: the long stroke, the short stroke, then the bottom crashing, the bottom bouncing basically, and then the shake. And with those four, if you master those and then kind of mix it up with the fish, many times you're going to get those fish to bite.